India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving the way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. Known as the warrior of peace around the world, Mahatma Gandhi was popular for his principles of love, hope, non-violence and sacrifice. Each year, his birthday is celebrated on the 2nd of October as Gandhi Jayanti in India and other countries to honour his contribution to the formation of a new and independent India. This year too, the day was celebrated in a number of different ways amid the worldwide pandemic. Have a look.
Also called as the father of the nation, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi is still a source of inspiration for many leaders and bureaucrats around the world. 2nd October, the day which marks his birth anniversary, is observed with much enthusiasm every year and is one of the officially declared national festivals of India. This year marked the 151st birth anniversary of the leader, and somber celebrations were held across various parts of the country to honour Gandhi's contribution to the freedom struggle and celebrate his non-violent way of life.
Gandhi ji ka janm divas hai aur Gandhi ji ko pura desh aur desh hi nahi pura vishw aaj उत्सव मना रहा है गांधी जी के लिए, चूंकि वो हमारे राष्ट्रपिता थे जी, और देश के लिए उनका जो योगदान है वो अमूल्य है, अतुल्य है, जो उनका पैरेलल कोई अभी तक हुआ ही नहीं है।
इंडियन प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी लेड द नेशन इन पेइंग होमेज टू द आइकॉनिक फ्रीडम मूवमेंट लीडर एट हिज मेमोरियल इन न्यू दिल्ली टू मार्क द ऑस्पिशियस डे। Modi, along with other leaders, including President Ramnath Kovind, offered flowers at Rajghat and remembered the father of the nation on the occasion. Each year, the quiet atmosphere of Ahmedabad's Sabarmati Ashram buzzes with bhajans and prayers in Mahatma's primary abode, with school children and other dignitaries being a part of the occasion. However, this year, amid the prevailing situation of the pandemic, prayers were held with minimum participation of people, without any elaborate programs and functions.
वो परंपरा आज चालू रखने के लिए जो भी नियम है डिस्टेंस का और बाकी का, वो नियम रख के बहुत ही मर्यादित संख्या में हमने यहाँ सर्वधर्म प्रार्थना का छोटा सा एक आयोजन, कोई वक्तव्य और कोई प्रोग्राम नहीं है, सिर्फ प्रार्थना करके हम अलग हो जाएं।
In Rameshwaram city of Tamil Nadu, few locals were seen offering garlands to the effigy of Mahatma Gandhi and pledging to adhere by the leader's principles of non-violence and national unity. In Chandigarh city, an artist named Varun Tandon remembered the leader by making an attractive portrait of Mahatma Gandhi with bowed face and stick in his hand. The 25 by 11 feet portrait was made with around 2 kgs of salt in a span of 8 hours. According to Varun, the usage of salt in this portrait is significant because Gandhi started the salt satyagraha from Sabarmati, which led to the beginning of Indian independence struggle.
एक टाइम था जब अंग्रेजों ने नमक के ऊपर टैक्स लगा दिया था, तो जो महात्मा गांधी थे उन्होंने अहमदाबाद से लेके डांडी जो एक जगह है वहाँ तक एक पैदल मार्च किया, जिससे नमक की जो है प्रोडक्शन इंडिया में शुरू होने के लिए वो था, उससे प्रेरित होकर मैंने गांधी जी की जो पोर्ट्रेट है वो नमक से तैयार की।
On June 15, the United Nations declared Mahatma Gandhi's birthday as the International Day of Non-Violence, with the motive of securing a culture of peace, tolerance, understanding, and non-violence cohering to these principles on which Gandhi's life was based on.
Being home to 1.3 billion denizens who belong to different castes and communities, India displays an amazing characteristic of mutual tolerance and peaceful coexistence. Examples defining this unique identity of the country are to be found at its every nook and corner. One among them is a small village in Jammu and Kashmir's Anantnag district, where people of various faiths live together in complete harmony.
मजहब नहीं सिखाता आपस में बैर रखना, हिंदी है हम, वतन है हिंदुस्तान हमारा। इफ वन नीड्स टू नो द एक्चुअल मीनिंग ऑफ दीज लिरिक्स, देन दिस विलेज इन अनंतनाग डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर वुड बी परफेक्ट प्लेस फॉर हिम। Known as Mutton, people of different sects reside here with peace and brotherhood. Be it a temple, mosque or gurudwara, the village has it all, making it a beautiful example of religious diversity. The local says that people of various faiths have been living here together for ages and have never let their religion create a rift among them.
मैं पाया हम सब जगह घूमते, हम हर जगह निकलते, मेरे यार बरादरी इतनी है बचपन से, यहाँ मुस्लिम बरादरी इतनी मेरे यार दोस्त हैं, सब मेरा स्वागत करते हैं और हम भी उनके साथ रल मिलकर बैठते हैं। बहुत आनंद आता है हमें, कोई यहाँ महसूस नहीं होता है हमें, कोई यहाँ कोई कुछ नहीं महसूस होता कि, क्योंकि यहाँ बरादरी है, हम बैठते हैं आपस में मिलते, वो आज भी आते हैं हमारे पास मिलते हैं, मिलजुल कर हम काम करते हैं, हर फंक्शन हम आते हैं। मैं भगवान का, परमात्मा का शुक्रगुजार हूँ, सबका परमात्मा का शुक्रगुजार हूँ कि यहाँ ऐसा माहौल है। ये माहौल मुझे नहीं लगता है कश्मीर में कहीं भी।
For the evidences, before 1990s, the village had a greater population of Hindus and Sikhs residing together along with Muslims. However, in 1990s, due to insurgency, a number of Pandit families left the valley and migrated to Jammu and other places of the country. But after 1996, many families returned back, and today they are again living peacefully with their Muslim neighbors. Today, be it happy occasion like marriage or sorrowful event like last riots, they freely visit each other's household and even help each other whenever required.
यहाँ का जो माहौल है हमारा एकदम बढ़िया है, सबसे अच्छा है, यानी कि पूरा वर्ल्ड में सबसे बेहतरीन हमारी ये मटन की एक जगह है, ख़ास इसकी अहमियत है। यहाँ पर मंदिर है, गुरुद्वारा है और बागीचा हमारी, यहाँ पर आगे हमारा मस्जिद भी है और आस्थान भी है हमारा। और सबसे अच्छी बात है यहाँ का कल्चर हमारा, हिंदू मुसलमानों, हिंदू का और मुसलमानों का और सिखों का एक भाईचारा है यहाँ पर जो कायम है अभी तक और आगे भी रहेगा, जो भी नई जनरेशन है उससे भी आगे आएगी।
हम यहाँ हिंदू मुसलमान पंडित रहते हैं और हम एक दूसरे की शादियों पर जाते हैं, एक जब एक दूसरे कोई मर जाता है उनके घर जाते हैं, सब हिंदू हमारे घर आते हैं, हम उनके जाते हैं, मुसलमान के घर जाते हैं।
The way in which Mutton village has kept its tradition of oneness alive even during tough times, clearly shows that no religion is greater than the religion of humanity.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
In a bid to conserve water, Vadodara administration has successfully set up rainwater harvesting projects in 1,000 government schools in the district. The project named Varsha Jal Nidhi, which is completed at a cost of Rs. 6 crores, has received grants from the public as well as private enterprises under corporate social responsibility.
वर्षा जल निधि एक प्रोजेक्ट है जो वडोदरा डिस्ट्रिक्ट में ग्रामीण विस्तारों में जितने भी स्कूल्स हैं उसमें रेन वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग बनाए हैं. 1000 स्कूल्स हैं पूरे डिस्ट्रिक्ट में और सभी 1000 स्कूल में सिर्फ 9 मास में ये रेन वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग स्ट्रक्चर्स बनाने में आए हैं और वडोदरा देश का प्रथम डिस्ट्रिक्ट बन गया है जहाँ पे कि सभी स्कूल्स में रेन वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग स्ट्रक्चर्स बनाए हैं.
विद दिस प्रोजेक्ट as much as 10 crore liters of water will be stopped from being wasted every year from the government school campuses. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurated the world's longest high altitude tunnel in the northern Himalayan state of Himachal Pradesh. The 9.02 kilometer long tunnel that provides all weather road connectivity to its troops stationed in Ladakh is considered strategically important by India. Situated at the height of 10,044 feet, the tunnel will link up with a highway that is still under construction, opening the snow deserts of Ladakh to the rest of the country all year round when ready.
Connectivity ka desh ke vikas se seedha sambandh hota hai. Jyada se jyada connectivity yani utna hi tej vikas. Khaskar बॉर्डर एरिया में तो कनेक्टिविटी सीधे सीधे देश की रक्षा जरूरतों से जुड़ी होती है.
With thousands of its troops amassed at the border and no sign of a drawdown, India is now pushing harder to blast and smash its way through the Himalayas. The tunnel costs nearly $478 million and took 10 years to complete. India's famous Bengal Safari Park in West Bengal's Siliguri city reopened for tourists after over 6 months of coronavirus shutdown. The Forest Department had last allowed the parks in the state to reopen with mandatory safety precautions. Visitors will have to wear mask at all times and maintain physical distance at the park. Tourists expressed their joy as they visited the park after months.
बहुत अच्छा लग रहा था. पहले तो नहीं आ पा रहे थे, बहुत मन टूट गया था, एकदम से दुखी लग रहा था. तो तब नहीं आ पा रहे थे तो ऐसा लग रहा कि क्या हुआ यहाँ आए. तो अब सफारी में जब आए तब हम लोगों को लग रहा है ऐसे कि हाँ, बहुत खेलने का एक मैदान मिल गया और सफारी में बहुत जानवर भी थे, पंछी भी थे और देखने में इन लोगों को तो बहुत खूबसूरत लग रहा था.
The park, spread in an area of over 700 acres, offers tiger, elephant, leopard, Asiatic black bear and mixed herbivore safaris. It has an aviary trail, lesser cats trail, gharials and crocodile ponds too. India's Himalayan territory of Ladakh organized a two-day mountain biking festival to promote and diversify the scope of tourism in the territory. The event aimed to draw adventure junkies from across the world for adventure tourism in the region, which is mostly dependent on local agriculture and cultural tourism. The festival invited both professional and amateur riders to participate in the event from across the country. However, only few could make it to the final round.
इतने high altitude पे I don't think कोई भी race world में होती है. तो अगर यहाँ पे एक world class event किया जाए, तो सबके लिए एक नया challenge रहेगा. इतने altitude पे जब पेडलिंग करना पड़ेगा तो आपका ब्रीदिंग टेक्निक एवरीथिंग विल मैटर. तो हाई अल्टीट्यूड के ऊपर डेफिनेटली सबके लिए इट विल बी अ चैलेंजिंग फॉर वर्ल्ड क्लास एथलीट्स आल्सो. इट विल बी अ चैलेंजिंग एक्सपीरियंस एंड इट विल डेफिनेटली बी अ फन टू राइड हियर.
लोकेटेड इन द डेजर्ट्स ऑफ हिमालयन रीजन, लद्दाख इज वन ऑफ द हाईएस्ट इनहैबिटेड प्लेसेस इन द वर्ल्ड अबव सी लेवल.
India has remained a land of great saints, assimilating in its fold various cultures and faiths from time to time. It is a land where Sufism has not only flourished in its true spirit, but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. A glimpse of it can be witnessed in Shrine of Chansa Baba in Midnapore district of West Bengal, where people from different religions come to pay tributes and pray for their well-being. Take a look.
For centuries, the Shrine of Chansa Baba in Midnapore district of West Bengal has served as a cynosure of unification between myriad faiths practiced in India. No matter which caste or community they belong to, devotees bow their head before the shrine and offer their respect to the revered Sufi saint and pray for the well-being of their family.
I was amazed and I was very happy to see that the people, irrespective of caste, race and religion, they come and pay their homages to Chansa Baba, great Chansa Baba. This Chansa Baba, when I read a book about him, he was a very, very common person. He was a down-to-earth person. And he used to move everywhere, not thinking about his own status, own respect. No, he didn't care anything. He was fully occupied with the God's idea.
Situated in Ballavpur Mirza Mohalla area of Midnapore district, the holy site is thronged by a number of devotees every year. Sufi Saint Chansa Baba was a renowned figure among the people of Midnapore. During his entire life, he worked for the well-being of humanity and promoted love and brotherhood. In 1980, after the demise of the Sufi saint, a shrine was built in his honor by one of his Hindu disciples, Chamat Kumar Setua, so as to spread the message of saint and promote camaraderie among the people of different faiths.
यहाँ जो जो मानत करके आते बाबा अपनी काम के लिए आते बाबा तो कर देता बाबा का दर्जा में कोई खाली हाथ से नहीं आता बाबा कुछ ना कुछ दुआ करता है.
Since ages, the Sufi saints like Chansa Baba have propagated the message of spiritualism and harmony in our country, and their teachings are still playing a significant role in binding different faiths together.
It's been said that any society that fails to harness the energy and creativity of its women is at a huge disadvantage in the modern world. Women nowadays are breaking all cultural, gender and social stereotypes and are making their marks in almost all the fields which were once said to be male-dominated. In order to shatter similar stereotypes against women drivers and establish that they are no different to men drivers, a female car rally was recently organized in Srinagar city of Jammu and Kashmir.
In a bid to fight stereotypes against women drivers in Jammu and Kashmir, a first-of-its-kind female car rally was recently organized in the capital city of Srinagar. Titled Myth Busters of Kashmir, the rally was collectively organized by a global non-government organization in association with the Jammu and Kashmir Traffic Police. Participants in the rally were seen rejoicing as they drove through the streets of Srinagar in full spirit with a motive of spreading the message of women empowerment among other citizens passing by.
मुझे लगता है कि इस तरह की रैलीज तो होनी चाहिए. आई फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई लाइक टू कंग्रेचुलेट द ऑर्गेनाइजर्स जिन्हें इतना अच्छा एक इवेंट ऑर्गेनाइज किया है, एंड आई ट्रूली फील ऑनर टू बी पार्ट ऑफ दिस इवेंट. और इस तरह की रैलीज होनी चाहिए. इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू क्रिएट अवेयरनेस अमंग द मासेस, और इससे हमारी फीमेल ड्राइवर्स को भी काफ़ी एनकरेजमेंट मिलेगी और एक वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट का एक सोर्स है. तो इस तरह की रैलीज तो होनी चाहिए.
स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द हेडक्वार्टर्स ऑफ ट्रैफिक पुलिस श्रीनगर, the rally passed through major landmarks in the city like Dak Park and the famous Boulevard Road which runs along the Dal Lake. All the people who participated in the rally pledged to respect women and acknowledge the fact that women drivers are no different than male drivers, as gender does not define skill sets in a person. The rally, with the participation of around 40 women, also had an opening event where this myth was discussed and awareness regarding the correct treatment of women drivers on roads was created.
People say कि ये अच्छी गाड़ियाँ नहीं चलाती हैं, इनकी वजह से ट्रैफिक जाम होता है. लोग इनको टीज करते हैं औरतों को कि आप लोग अच्छी गाड़ियाँ नहीं चला सकती. लेकिन जब हम घर चला सकते हैं, हम ऑफिस चला सकते हैं, तो हम गाड़ी क्यों नहीं चला सकते. सो दिस रैली इज to show them that we should respect a woman driver. Exactly, it's a source of woman empowerment. ये उसका एक स्पेक्ट्रम है, इसीलिए हम इस पर काम कर रहे हैं. लोग उनको दिखाना चाहते हैं कि औरतें आपसे बेटर ड्राइव कर सकती हैं. जैसे हमारी डॉक्टर शर्मीन है, शी इज़ एन ऑफ रोड ड्राइवर. तो जब एक औरत ऑफ रोड ड्राइवर हो सकती है, तो मुझे लगता है कि बहुत बड़ी बात है.
जो रिस्पेक्ट वुमेन ड्राइवर डिजर्व करते हैं उनको वो दे तो बात खत्म. मर्दों को कभी नहीं ऐसा होता ना. आपने कभी देखा है कभी कोई गाड़ी होती है इसके पीछे चलते हैं हम, ये फाइन ड्राइवर, इसकी स्पीड अच्छी है, सब कुछ अच्छा है. लेकिन हम जब लड़की देखते हैं ना चलाते हुए, यार इसके पीछे कौन चले, वी कांट ओवरटेक, स्लो हो जाएंगी इसकी वजह से. एक्चुअली टेक्निकली ये है कि आप इस फैक्ट्स उठा के देख लो, वुमेन ड्राइवर काफ़ी कम एक्सीडेंट्स में इन्वॉल्व होते हैं एज़ कम्पेयर टू मैन ड्राइवर. बस एक स्टीरियोटाइप है, एक हवा बना के रखी, अच्छा नहीं चला रहे, ऐसा है वैसा है. ऐसा एक्चुअली कुछ नहीं. मुझे लगता है जो औरत घर चला सकती है, गाड़ी चलाना ज़्यादा मुश्किल नहीं हो सकता. इसी मुझे अपनी माँ ने बड़ा किया है, ठीक है, मेरी बेटी है. मुझे लगता है जितना और कोई मुझे नहीं सुधार पाए, एक औरत सुधार सकती है. एंड आजकल की जो ट्रैफिक कंडीशंस है, वी शुड एनकरेज वुमेन ड्राइवर्स. एक्चुअली वी शुड फॉलो वुमेन ड्राइवर्स. बहुत सेफ है, पूरा अच्छे से देख परख के गाड़ी चलाते हैं. एंड आई थिंक वी शुड एनकरेज इट.
It is through these different and innovative steps that are being taken towards women empowerment that the society is slowly and steadily changing for the better.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@ain.com. I'm your host, Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.